Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to your Loras College broadcast. My name's Matthew. I'll be flying solo tonight on what should be a matchup for the ages. Your Loras College Jayhawks are hosting the Wartburg Knights, and it should be a great matchup. Loras coming into the game 9-5-1, 5-1 in the ARC, and the Wartburg Knights coming in 7-1-8, 3-0-4 in the ARC. A lot at stake in this game for both teams. Before this game, though, we have to say the Loras Women's College soccer team took the ARC championship and won conference against the Wartburg Knights women's team, and it was a great game. Just won that one 2-0, and a great effort all around from the Jayhawks. So this one should be a great game as well, as the boys team is lining up and getting ready for kickoff. Loras has clinched at least a share of the ARC regular season championship, but also could potentially be a part of a three-way tie with Wartburg and Luther. The Jayhawks can clinch a title outright with the win or a tie tonight. Loras is 9-0-1 in the last 10 meetings with Wartburg, and we're off. Jared's going to kick this one right to Reed. Reed's going to get it to Samson off to the side, and Samson's going to run down the sidelines in an attempt to get it in the goal, but it will be back out to Michael Brandt. Already a Jayhawk down and slow to get up. Looks like it's the sophomore, Michael K. Taylor Solwell off to the side. Gonna get it to Jose Cardenas, the junior. And the Wartburg Knights moving into their own territory, trying to make an opportunity here, which in this game, you'll have to capitalize on those opportunities, like right here in this one, right over the goal and through the goalpost. If we were playing football, that would have been good for 3 points. Starters for the Jayhawks, that goal, the junior Ben Krogman, Lucas Sampson, a senior from Wheaton, Illinois, Jared Block from Dubuque, Iowa, Felipe Ramirez from Chicago, and Kevin Kuchaba from St. Charles, Illinois. And a whistle already. Reed McClavick from Frankfort, Kentucky, Jose Cardenas from Eugene, Oregon, Michael Kay from Rockford, Illinois, Taylor Sowell from Rockford, Illinois, Michael Brand from Ankeny, Iowa, and the sophomore from Bone Terre, Missouri, Brian Bassinger. Michael Brand's going to kick this one high, but in the air, tries to connect with Reed, and he does. Reed kicks it to the left of him to Samson. Samson trying to make an opportunity out of it, and it's picked up by the goalie, Brennan Woody from Grimms, Dallas. Starting for the Wartburg Knights, Connor Ulumpa, number 3, from Burnsville, Minnesota. Andrew Venezuela from Omaha, Nebraska. Sam McDovitt from Attleboro, Northwest. Paul Devine from Council Bluffs. Caleb Harlan from Fairfax Prairie. Edvin Richvich from Waterloo, Iowa. Yushin Gossin from Lincoln, Nebraska. Anzernet Kimba from Rock Island, Illinois. Michael Dunn from Iowa City. And the junior from Cedar Rapids, Curtis Ratzer. Ben Krogman and Brennan Woody will be very busy tonight as the two teams are looking to score as many points as they can to separate themselves from each other and from Luther as well. And a collision at the 35. Both get back up. This one high up in the air, and it'll go right to number 13 for the Jayhawks, Michael K. Loras Loras this year, 30 goals compared to their opponent, 17. So Ben Krogman, very busy back there behind in front of the net. Goals per game, two, while our opponents are scoring 1.13 per game. And Cardenas will kick this one out of bounds on the opposite side of the field, and a Wartburg Knight is down. And we'll get a stoppage of play and a stoppage of the clock at 40 minutes and 53 seconds. Looks like it's number 20 for the Knights, and Zuna Kimba from Rock Island, Illinois. The 6'1 freshman, or excuse me, the 6'1 fifth year. Duhawks have 201 shots while their opponents are being held to 157. 13.4 shots per game while opponents are at 10.5. Shots on goal, 94 out of 201. Holding their opponents to 63 out of 157. Loras, a very aggressive and scrappy team, which is good, but can cost you a little bit as they have 17 yellow cards, but their opponents have 21. Loras rounding out the season as of now with three red cards and their opponents with one. I must say, Wartburg as well, high on the yellow card list with 32 and opponents 26. So expect an aggressive, scrappy, tough game from both teams. And it looks like the fifth year, Kimba is on his feet walking back to the sideline, which is great to see. Big rivalry here in Dubuque between Wartburg and Loras, but sportsmanship is always a must. As the Knights and Duhawks go back to their designated positions, we will resume play shortly as we get a Wartburg Knight substituting in for Kimba. Looks like it's number 9, Colby Fanner, a junior from Omaha, Nebraska. Cardenas gets this one off the knee, off the head of Reed Miklavik, and it looks like Woody will pick it up at the 5-yard line, deciding what to do with it as he bounces it. And Woody kicks this one far and high off the head of Bassinger at the opposite 20. And Reed on the other side of the field, and it'll be off of a Wartburg Knight. Looks like it was number 3, Connor Lumba. Lumba, a junior from Burnsville, Minnesota. Captain for the Duhawks is fifth-year Kevin Kuchaba. Has shown and established a lot of leadership on this team, and Sampson trying to make something out of that kick, and it'll be taken away from him by the Knights. So we get another whistle here. That Loras bench is cheering. And it looks like Taylor Sowell will be the one with the corner kick here. Could kick it all the way out to the 5 for some teammates or off to the side. Looks like Kevin Kuchab is standing right there, and he could be the one to kick it in. Reed Miklavik standing pretty close to the goal. Solwell will take it for himself. Connects with Bassinger on the opposite side of the field. Excuse me, Michael Kay on the opposite side of the field. This one will be back out to the other captain for the Duhawks, Jose Cardenas. This one will send block all the way out to the 20, and it'll be picked up by Krogman. Yeah. A lot of talking in soccer, whether you're on the field or on the bench. And that's being shown and heard here today in this game. Sampson at the five, trying to make it a 1-0 game if he can get some assistance, and it's taken away. But Reed trying to do everything he can to regain possession for the Duhawks, and it'll roll out of bounds. A throw in for the Wartburg Knights. Another opportunity here for them to go up 1-0. Number 17, Edvin Rizvik. And a throw in by number 3, Connor Ulumba. Bassinger playing some tough defense there. And this one is a goal for the Wartburg Knights. They lead 1-0. Just like that, Wartburg takes an early 1-0 lead. As the replay rolls in here, we'll break it down for you. Off to the side here, a crossover kick and right past the hand of Ben Krogman. Kimba hanging off to the side over there. Looks like he was kind of forgotten about. And he takes full advantage of that. Going up 1-0. And any goal is crucial in any game, but specifically in this game with the rivalry and what's at stake, that's a huge goal for Wartburg. Kimba trying to do it again. And it's off the shoulder of a Duhawk. Looks like Jared Block over there. It'll be a throw-in for Wartburg. Looks like Bassinger is credited with that throw-in. Number 4 for Wartburg, Andrew Valenzuela from Omaha, Nebraska, getting in on the action over there. And it'll be another throw-in for Bassinger. A couple leaders for the Loras. Duhawks. Taylor Solwell leads the team with 10 points. Michael Kay to Ramirez, and this one will be kicked out in a whistle. And another injured Wartburg Knight, this time inside the end zone. And looks like it could be a possible head injury. Going back to the leaders for the Duhawks, previously said, Tyler Solwell leading the team with 10 points. Reed McClavick right behind him with 8, and Michael Kay with 7 points. McClavick leads the team with 24 shots. Solwell right behind him with 3. Jared Block with 19. McClavick leads the team with 4 goals. Solwell with 3, and Michael Kay with 3. Shots on goal. Block leads the team with 11. Solwell with 10, and Michael Kay with 9. Solwell also leads the team with 4 assists. Felipe Ramirez checks in with 3, and Michael Brandt with 2. Looks like the injured Knight, number 22, Michael Dunn from Iowa City, is able to walk off under his own power, which is good to see. Resume play here quickly as the substitute for Dunn will check in, and when we find out who that is, we will let you know.
In the game for Wartburg, number 15, Parker Shimmers.
Parker Shimmers, the senior from Minshaw, Wisconsin, is in for the injured Knight. This one high up into the air and connects with Bassinger. Michael Kay gets it to Reed. Reed going to connect back to Michael Kay, this time on the opposite side of the field. And it's saved from going out of bounds from number 10, Caleb Halloran. Kujaba tries to connect with Sowell, and that would have been the top 10 Sports Center kick if that was going in. And Woody will hold on to the ball and wait for the Knights and the Duhawks to get back so he can send this one almost what looked like to the moon and back down. And it'll go out of bounds in favor of the Knights. Kuchaba trying to keep it from going out of bounds, but fails to do so. And so it'll be Wartburg's ball right back where they want it in front, or pretty close, at least on the right side of the field for them. And this one will be out of bounds off of a Duhawk. And it'll be back with Wartburg. Looks like it's going to be a corner kick for the Knights. And number 10, Caleb Halloran, the senior from Fairfax. Got a couple options here. Could go on the far side of the field or could go close to him. But that option on the closer to him is breaking apart. Go crashing in, and this one off of the bottom of the goalpost and on top of the net. And so Krogman, junior from Davenport, Iowa, is going to send this one deep from the edge of the end zone. The bottom of that R in Loras is where he'll kick it. Just skins the head of Reed McClavick. And this one is going to be a back-and-forth battle. You can already tell just the way these two teams are playing. And Ramirez is looking for something there. Substitution for the Wartburg Knights, checking in. Michael Dunn is going to check back in. A previously injured Knight is back into the game. And this one off the foot of Cardenas. And it'll be out of bounds with a throw-in from Wartburg. They're going to go deep with this one, but off the head of Cardenas. Off the head, looks like, of Michael Kay. And off the foot of Bassinger. Kuchaba tried to get in on that header trio and failed to do so, and it's the Knights' ball here. And it looks like Ramirez is on the ground. A lower leg injury is what it looked like, but he's back up. That grit and toughness of those Duhawks on full display here. Kick off to the left of Woody. And this long kick won't come from the goalie. Instead, it'll come from what looks like Michael Dunn. A throw in from Alumba, back to Alumba. And off the foot of Michael K. Aluma's going to throw it in just over the head of a teammate, and it's going to be off the foot of Bassinger, and good thing Michael Brandt was there because that could have gotten real bad real quick. Jared Block on the sideline trying to keep it in bounds for Loras. Instead, it'll roll out. He'll pick it right back up. But before he throws it in, we're going to get a whistle. And it looks like it'll be Wartburg's ball here for a throw-in for them. The throw-in for Wartburg. Off the head of Bassinger. And it looks like a Duhawk is down. Come on. like it was Ramirez who was on the ground, and this kick from Krogman will get picked up at the 45. Ramirez going to get it at the 50, and he's going to send a couple teammates on a mad dash to get that. Said it'll roll out of bounds, and it'll be a corner kick for Loras from number 14, Taylor Sowell. Like we said, Taylor Sowell in that leaderboard for the Duhawks. 3 goals, 21 shots, and 10 points. The corner from Sowell trying to get picked up by Bassinger, and this one will roll out of bounds. And so Bassinger will be tasked with this throw-in here. As you can see on your screen, looks like the Wartburg's women's team cheering on their fellow Knights. The header from Ramirez and right into the hands of Woody. And he'll pick that one up with ease, and he's signaling down for his teammates. Get ready, because it's coming. A long kick from the Knights, number 4, Andrew Valenzuela. And a hard hit from Ramirez. Will disrupt that connection for the Knights, and it's back out to the 55. Alumba, a little shifty footwork there, and he's going to get tripped up by the senior, Michael Brandt, and he's not too happy about that call. Just under 30 minutes left here in the first half of this massive rivalry game between Loras and Wartburg. Number 10, Caleb Helleran with the free kick off the head of a Knight. And a lot of yelling and communicating on that field. You can hear it from our boom mic down on the field. The kick from Krogman. Off the foot of Michael Kay. That one's off the head of Cardenas. And a high kick from Michael Kay. And Reed does a phenomenal job as usual and headed that one out of bounds without his feet touching out of bounds. So therefore, it stays in. Bassinger, a deflection off of his foot will lead to hopefully a connection with the Duhawk, and that will not happen. Kachaba kicks it right to a Knight, and he's going to kick this one right down the field into the hands of Benjamin Krogman. Samson getting tripped up. No call there. And back to Krogman, and he'll wait a couple seconds to gets a few things situated, and we've already got a yellow card. Looks like on the Duhawks, number 6, Felipe Ramirez. And that's 18 for the Duhawks. 18 yellow cards on the season.
Number 6, Felipe Ramirez.
It looks like the ref's going to go have a quick word with Ben Krogman. We'll see what it's about. Fall is in full effect here in Dubuque as you see those leaves falling down right behind this Ben Krogman on your screen, and it dropped drastically in the past couple days, the weather. And with the weather getting colder, that only means one thing, playoff soccer. And we'll get that here in Dubuque with the women's team hosting the game as they get a first round bye. A great win by Coach Matt Pucci and his players. Passing her again with the throw-in. Jared Block comes out of nowhere and gets that one, and he's going to get tripped up. And this one is a goal for the Dewhawks. A goal for Loras, and they tie it up 1-1. Michael Kay with the goal as the replay will roll right in. What an awesome opportunity for the sophomore. As the replay shows here, Bassinger is going to kick that one off the hands of Woody, off the goalpost, and Michael Kay got a little help from a teammate that can either be good or bad. That goalpost reflected right back to him, and he took full advantage of that, and that one off the back of Kuchaba, and it's picked up by a Knight. Before you know it, we're already on the other side of the field. Valenzuela. Oh, and Krogman jumps out of the goal for that one. And another Knight is slow to get up. What a save by Krogman, and that injured Knight still a little slow to get up. It looks like the injured Wartburg Knight is number 20. And Zunari Kimba. And he'll walk over to that lower sideline and make his way back to his team's bench. Just a little over 25 minutes to play here in the first half. And so far, we haven't been let down one bit of what was going to be a great game and what is still a great game. And a lot more soccer left to be played here in Dubuque.
In for Wartburg, number 9, Kobe Fanner.
Kobe Fanner is in for the injured Knight. It looks like Ramirez back there to pick it up. He's going to connect with Michael Kay. Reed McLavick on the sidelines, and he'll roll out of bounds. He'll quickly pick that up. He's got Ramirez off to his right. But before he throws it in, he'll take a quick pause while Bassinger makes his way over to the sideline to resume play. Kevin Kuchaba in that goal. Michael Brandt there as well, and this one going to be out of range for the Dewhawks, but Bassinger is going to kick it into some traffic. So well, and that one is going to be no good. Correction, that was Alex Beausoleil, senior from Wheaton, Illinois. Those opportunities don't come a lot, and when they do, you got to take advantage. This corner kick from So Well will go right to Kevin Kuchaba, back to So Well. And back to Kuchaba. Into some traffic, and this one will be headed back out to Beausoleil off the side of the head of a Wartburg Knight. Looks like number 8, Paul Devine, appears to be okay. And one of the captains for Wartburg, Caleb Hallerman, will kick this. Ooh. out of some traffic, and Kevin Kuchaba looks like he got rocked. Appears to be okay as he gets back up. And what a deflection off the ankle of Felipe Ramirez. This one will go out of bounds, and Wartburg will pick it up. Number four for Wartburg, Andrew Vesuela. And a hard hit. Well, Michael Brandt can kick it harder, and he kicks this one pretty far, just over the 30. On the opposite side of the field, and Reed McClavick fighting to get to that ball. And Reed throwing his hands up in the air. Not much to do on that one. He's getting held, but looked like he was getting held a little bit. And so Michael Dunn will kick this one off the head of Bassinger. Beausoleil in the game for the Dewhawks. Said his name a couple times just a few moments ago. And it'll be picked up by Woody. Woody kicks this one off the head of Kuchaba. He got up to get that. And Beausoleil quickly will throw this one in. Rush to the Wartburg bench to pick that up. Ooh. And Sowell. And a strong and high kick from Ben Krogman. Over the head of Kuchaba. Michael Kay coming out of nowhere. And Michael Dunn kicking this one to the opposite side of the field off of the foot of Cardenas. Bassinger there to kick it past a couple knights, and we'll get a stoppage of play. See on your screen a few Loras Dewhawks getting ready to warm up and come into this game to relieve some of their teammates. Off the head of Beausoleil and off the foot of Block. Off the head of Kuchaba, back to Beausoleil. That one was intended for Reed, but was intercepted by number 22, Michael Dunn. That was about three headers right there between three different Wartburg Knights. Wartburg still trying to extend the lead as well as Loras in this 1-1 game. Number eight, Paul Devine. And it'll be Loras' ball, it looks like. And it's blocked with the throw-in. Off the head of Reed. But it'll go back to Wartburg as they set it up here. This one all the way down to the other side of the field. off the head of Michael Brandt and off the foot of Brandt. Trying to get it picked up by Sowell. Ooh, and he gets hit hard. Right in front of our camera, down on the field. And we'll get a sub for the Wartburg Knights here. Looks like Connor Alumba will be throwing it in here for Wartburg.
In for Wartburg, number 16, Connor Wahlberg.
We have another Connor into the game. Connor Wahlberg, the freshman from Anarchy, Iowa. Connor Wahlberg will be wearing number 16 tonight. Cardenas wanted to throw that one in. We'll give it up to Bassinger, and this one off the head of a Knight, and that was number 8, Paul Devine. Bassinger quickly to pick that one up and quickly to throw it in. And connects with Sowell. And Kuchaba there in the mix. And this one high up into the air. Looks like Sobol's waiting for it to come down. He gets pushed to the ground. And it looks like Reed will get a free kick here. Up, correction. Looks like it'll either be Reed or Kevin Kuchaba. They discussed the game plan as to how they want to attack. That's a perfect opportunity for Loras to take the lead here. As to who kicks it, we'll see. Looks like it's Reed. A low one. Connecting with Bassinger was his plan, but instead, Bassinger will throw it in. He's going to take a hop, skip, and a jump for this one. And he'll just throw this to Michael Kay. Fools out everybody on that field. Michael Brandt chasing after that ball to keep it alive for the Duhawks. That one was out of bounds, and it'll stay with Loras. Bassinger again with the throw in. And this one is a tremendous throw from Brian Bassinger. Beausoleil there off the head of Bassinger, off the head of Brandt, and off the head of Sowell, and out of bounds off of Loras. Brennan Woody, looks like he will place this one down. Calling out to his teammates. The kick, looks like it'll go right. Bassinger with the header there, and Sowell getting pushed to the ground once again, but Reed has it. Like, it's broken up by a few Knights. Out of bounds, and Cardenas will quickly throw this one in, right in the direction of number 17, Edvin Rizvik. And Rizvik, a big player for Wartburg. Rizvik leads the team with points in points with 11, and leads the team with 20 shots on goals. Also leads the team with 4 goals. So Rizvik, a big player, as he's a senior from Waterloo. Out of bounce. Off of Kevin Kuchaba and number 5, Sam McDivitt. We'll throw it in. Bassinger gets pushed to the ground. And it's going to be a kick from Felipe Ramirez. Off the head of Michael Kay, and this will roll out of bounds. Ramirez comes in quick. We'll get a whistle. Number 25 for Wartburg, Curtis Ratzer. Junior from Cedar Rapids, Iowa. Klavik gonna kick this one to Bostula. He slips up as he kicks that, but still manages to get it down the field. Cardenas gets this to Klavik. Klavik gets to the passing room, but before that, the ref had to move out of the way for that kick to connect. Cardenas breaks up that opportunity for Wartburg, and now he's on the ground in some pain. Looks like it'll be Kuchaba with the kick here. Kuchaba leading his teammates with that kick, and it's off the head of a Wartburg Knight, but into the feet of Michael Kay. Michael Kay will get this to block. Block has the potential to connect here with Reed. And still in play, it looks like, but we'll get a whistle, and Reed wants a call. Looks like he won't get it. Instead, he'll come out of the game here. It looks like number 22, Carson Woods is going to check into the game. Ooh, a lot of action going on over there on the end zone. Taylor Sowell and number 22, Michael Dunn, get caught in a scuffle, and Dunn's trying to plead his case. Replay, we'll break that down for you as to what happened and what Dunn was trying to explain. Looks like Sowell trying to get up, and Dunn just pushing him down, and ref stopped it before it got real bad. But Kuchaba with the kick here, and this is off the goalpost, and a missed opportunity for Loras. And they got to keep pushing through. Holy moly, that would have been a 2-1 lead for the Dewhawks if that was just a few inches to the left. And Instead, Brennan Woody is kicking this from the R in Loras. That one off the head of Beausoleil. This one will be rolling out of bounds, picked up by the Knights. Chaba trying to make it happen for his teammates. Instead, he's going to get tripped up, and that's going to go uncalled. Beausoleil trying to help him out there by getting that back, and it's Bassinger getting it to Block, and Block getting it to Beausoleil. Beausoleil on the sidelines here, trying to make it happen as well. Trying to make up from that missed opportunity on the goalpost, and Bassinger is going to kick this one out of bounds. Just under 7 minutes remaining in the first half, and it's been a good one. Not disappointed one bit. A lot of opportunities for Loras and Wartburg. A lot of action in this game, and excited to see what happens in these 6.5 minutes and what's in hold for the second half. As there is a lot at stake in this game, not just for these two teams, but for the ARC. A sliding kick from Bassinger as he connects with Beausoleil, and that's broken up. What a rocket kick from Jared Block, picked up by Sowell. He's got Kuchaba on a chase. Kuchaba's going to turn around. He's going to kick this one back to Sowell. Sowell tripped up there but maintains his feet. That one was intended, it looks like, for Michael Kay. And Ramirez kicks this to Carson Woods, and this one couldn't be picked up by the Duhawks. This is the Knights and Duhawks. We zoom play here. Bassinger. Gonna get this to Beausoleil. An opportunity for Loras. And Woody comes way out of that goal. Communicating to his teammates as they're running back down to midfield. And a monstrous kick from Woody. Great job by Jared Block, just sticking a foot out there and trying to keep it with the Duhawks. A lot of back and forth in this game. And Bassinger is going to go flying, and that's going to be in possession of Loras. And Jared Block kicks that one straight to Cardenas. Cardenas to Michael Kay, and he's making a run for it. It'll be a throw-in for the Duhawks. Bassinger tasked with that throw-in. We approach the 4 minute mark in the first half. We get a throw in from Bassinger. And this one is a goal for Loras. Over the hands of Brennan Woody. And the Duhawks and that bench are going crazy. A replay here. Throwing from Bassinger. Off the head of Jared Block. And it's a 2-1 lead for Loras. Logan Hartzell in for the Wartburg Knights, the freshman from St. Louis, Missouri. And that's the goal that Loras needed. That's the goal to separate themselves in going into halftime. And that's big for Loras going into it with some momentum. And we'll see how Wartburg responds in the next 3.5 minutes and responding going into halftime, what game plan they come up with. Michael Kay going to kick it over to Sowell off to his right. Sowell going to step on it and put the brakes on. Carson Woods messing around in there and gets out of it quickly. Kuchaba just passes the 10-yard line, and this could have been a 3-1 game. And that Duhok bench trying to get the ball in quick. Time's ticking to extend this lead. And if you're Wartburg, you got to do everything you can on this side of the field with the time left to make sure Loras doesn't score and further the lead. Brendan Woody and his teammates got to do everything they can to shut Loras down. An opportunity. Ramirez, and this one right past the goal. Woody will just send this over to a teammate as he escapes the end zone, and he's holding so well. And that's going to be a foul. Number 25, Curtis Ratzer. He's the one throwing so well to the ground. Sowell will fake that kick, and now it's Kuchaba's turn. Looks like they were trying to connect with Bassinger. Ramirez going to give it another shot, and that one going to end up the same way the other kick ended up, just right past the goal. Woody's got a couple teammates, Michael Dunn and Ratzer. As those two will just evade the plan and they'll go down the field. Kuchaba getting it tripped up at the 50. That's going to be a no call for the Duhawks. And this one's going to roll out of bounds, and Krogman stops it from rolling out. Just under 1 minute remaining here in the first half. And Krogman's calling to his teammates, move up. We still got 50 seconds left in this first half. And a yellow card. With 46 seconds left in the first half. Once again, the ref wanted a little explanation and further detail. And Krogman kicks this one high up. Not sure if that's how he wanted it to go. But Loras will have to play it from there. That yellow card accredits one of the captains for Loras, Kevin Kuchaba. 19 on the season for the Duhawks. Seconds remain here in the first half. Loras leading 2-1 against the rival Wartburg Knights.
10, 9, 8, 7.
Knights
six,
trying to at five, least keep Loras
four,
from scoring.
Three, two,
and they do so one. Successfully. So after one, Loras leads by one with a 2-1 score here in the Rock Bowl. We'll be back with a lot more game left to play, and a lot could happen in that second half. Welcome back to the second half of Loras College Soccer. Your Loras Duhawks are up 2-1 to the Wartburg Knights. At the half, Luther College is up 3-0 against Coe College. So if Luther wins and Wartburg wins, it is a three-way tie between Loras, Luther, and Wartburg. Unless the Duhawks can get it done here with this lead at the half and win this game, Loras will take the victory in the ARC Championship and win the conference heading into the tournament. But we will find out if that still stands with 45 minutes left to play here in the second half. Wartburg will start out with the ball, but before we resume, the Duhawks have a quick word with one another as they huddle up. Green McLavick hyped up. As usual, the big motivator for this team. On the field and off the field. A lot at stake in this second half, like we mentioned as we were wrapping up the first. A lot can happen. And this one will start with a header from Cardenas, and it'll roll out of bounds right in front of our camera. Number four, Andrew Venezuela with a throw-in. Kuchaba is going to kick this one. Just right to Brennan Woody. It's like Jared Black. Gonna kick this, gonna connect with a teammate, and now the Knights keep this one in bounds. Getting pressured, and that's so well with some energy coming out of the halftime. This one, passing a couple Duhawks, and Krogman will jump right on that. And some players getting set here as it looks like number 8 for the Wartburg Knights. Ball Devine is going to get the free kick here. Free kick from Devine as they're going to rush to the goal, and Krogman's going to get it off his hands. He's going to get back in time, and this one will roll right past the goal. A missed opportunity for Wartburg. If they're going to want to keep up in this game with Loras, they're going to have to capitalize and execute on those free kicks and those opportunities. Krogman, the junior from Davenport, Iowa. With a strong kick there, and Kuchaba looks like he was going to do a windmill, and he just stopped to halfway. Reed McLavick on the loose here, and we could see if he can make it a 3-1 game, and that kick is blocked. Wartburg saves it, but it'll head out of bounds. McLavick escaped the hands of Wartburg. And that could have gotten bad once again. Bassinger with the throw-in. And that's a strong and far one from him. And that's a windmill kick right past the goal, and that could have been on SportsCenter tomorrow morning when you're eating your Cheerios. You probably would have seen that one. Let's go. Looks like that was Taylor Sowell, if I'm correct, with that almost windmill goal. Off the head of Reed. This one high up into the air. Jared Block slides in and interrupts that connection between the Knights. This will roll out of bounds in favor of Loras. And a quick stretch for Jared Block before he throws this one in, and we'll see who he connects with. Looks like this will roll out of bounds, and it looks like Cardenas was trying to chase it down before he said, you know what, save my energy. It's the sophomore Bassinger with the throw-in once again. Bassinger throws it in, tries to connect with Sowell. And a little bit of a trip up there at the 40 between McLavick and number 5, Sam McDivitt. Broken up by Sowell. Picked up by Wartburg. Block's been busy all night guarding some of these tough Wartburg players. Cardenas will let this one roll out of bounds. Throw in from Bassinger. This one will roll out of bounds from that throw in, and it's picked up by number 8, Paul Devine. And just a quick little kick there for the Knights as they want to set something up here if they can. But before they do, Beausoleil gets in on the action, and Ramirez and Bassinger. This one right past the goal. Number 17, Edvin Rizvik with that kick. Krogman waving over a couple players for Loras. We'll see if that plan follows through. Looks like it doesn't, but a strong kick from Krogman past the 50. Wanted to connect with the player as he falls back. Looks like that was Bassinger, the intended player. But a strong kick nonetheless here. And McLavick down inside the end zone. If he can get some help from some players. Ooh, and he gets shoved. We'll get a stoppage of the clock as the Wartburg Knight is still down on the ground. Reed off of his back sitting. Reed McLavick seeking some medical attention here on the field. Number 4 was the injured Knight, Andrew Valenzuela, junior from Omaha, Nebraska. McLavick getting some help to his feet. And some great sportsmanship shown there. One of the Wartburg players in McLavick's going to head over. The way that arm looks like it's hanging, it looks like it could be an arm injury, so not good for the Duhawks. McLavick, a strong player for Loras. Talk about him being a leader and a big motivator on and off the field.
Number 22, Carson Woods.
Carson Woods is going to check in for Loras, and that's a big loss if McLavick can't come back into this game. I mean, they have a lead 2-1, but you wonder how long can they hold on to it with one of their star players being out. Number 25, Curtis Ratzer, will be the one with the kick here off the head of block. And Woods already getting busy early, chasing down that ball. Wartburg off the goalpost and into the net. Like I said, that goalpost could be your best friend or your worst enemy. And it's Wartburg's best friend here, as this game is now tied 2-2.
Wartburg goal, number 10, Craig Hiram. Assist by number 10, Enzerini comeback.
That goal for Wartburg, number 6, Colton Praska, and we're going to break it down here with the replay as it rolls in momentarily. Here it is. The assist off the goalpost and into the net. And just like that, we've got a tie game here at the Rock Bowl. I have spoken too soon on how long that lead could have lasted. I'd say about that lasted about 20 seconds. Assinger gets stripped up at the 50 and play is back in session here. Wartburg Knight a little slow to get up, but he's back on his feet. Number 3, Connor Alumba with the throw in here off the foot of Michael Kay. So well, gonna get shoved to the ground. Ooh, and it looks like he's holding on to that ankle. Hopefully he's okay. They can't lose Smiklavik and Solwell. That would be a huge loss for the Two Hawks. A lot of communication and yelling going down on that field. Loras wants to take full advantage of this as they need to capitalize on these opportunities now without Smiklavik and a tie game. Reed Smiklavik, like I said, leads the team with 4 goals. And so not having him out here really is a hurter, but a guy like Kevin Kuchaba, as you see on your screen, is one that's going to have to step up. But before we get the kick, we get a whistle. A lot of pushing and shoving going on down there, and we'll see if they can capitalize here as Woods is going to chase that one down, but before he can get it, it goes out of bounds. He comes sprinting out of there, ready to play. Brendan Woody here with the kick. Looks like Ramirez had the header there. This one off of Michael Brandt's head. Michael K keeps it in bounds for Loras, but it's going to get picked up by Wartburg Knight. Another opportunity for Wartburg here. This one, it's going to roll out of bounds, but they're going to take full advantage. They hurry up on this throw-in. Number 3, Alumba was ready to throw that one in. Stopped by Brandon. Brandon will kick that one high up into the air. Andrew Vizuela gets it so well. Tripped up once again, but he's back up on his feet. Chaba hands on his head. Oh. Bessinger, a human wall out there, blocking a couple kicks with his chest. Chaba, ooh, and Bessinger gets hit hard. He's on the ground. Michael Brandt with the kick here. Beausoleil. It looks like it's Michael K with the big run down there, but he can't quite get to it. So now Loras has an opportunity here as we get a throw in from Bessinger. Put some points up on the board if they can. Another throw in from Bessinger. Carson Woods there, and he'll stay with the Duhawks. A throw in, and that one has some hands up into the air. We're going to get a corner kick here. Looks like it's either going to be from Sowell or Kuchaba. Sowell will dish that out to Kuchaba. Michael Brandt has an opportunity here, and it just goes right past the goal, but it stays in bounds. Kuchaba kicks it over. This one, and a stop by Woody, but can he do it again? And he does! Brendan Woody does the impossible. And a deserved break is what he takes. A replay here on what a phenomenal stop from Woody. Motions his guys to get back. He's ready to play. Replay here as we'll break it down. That phenomenal stop by Brennan Woody. Back into the action here. And Jose Cardenas is trying to plead his case for a potential foul. Just under 30 minutes to play here in the second half of what's been nothing short but an electric game here in the Rock Bowl. And finally, play resumes, and Brandt with the kick. Off the head of Bessinger. Bessinger is going to try to replay that, and he's dadded down the field. Along with a convoy of Duhawks. Carson Woods turns the wheels on, and this one kicked out of bounds in the Wartburg bench. Loving that energy. Krogman ready to kick this one off. A header from Block. This one kicked and it goes right past the goal. And it's going to be a corner for the Knights. Caleb Hellerm with the corner. Perhaps kicked that one a little too far and missed an opportunity. And Carson Woods is going to get hit. But before he does, he heads that one. Krogman rolls this one out to the 11 and kicks it at the 11. Massinger got up for that one, and it looks like it'll be on Wartburg. The senior Felipe Ramirez with the free kick here. Ramirez with the kick. And this one, just a little too far. Woody with the kick. Woody tries to connect with a teammate, broken up by Ramirez. Wartburg trying to extend that lead like they've been trying to do all night. Now they've caught up. So instead of playing catch up, they're trying to take the lead. A lot of noise coming from that crowd. Had a great turnout for the women's game. And a good turnout for the men's game here. Wartburg brought a good amount of fans, but when you have home field advantage, you want to take advantage of that. And Loras did just that for the women's game in here tonight for the men's game. Off the head of Sowell, Kuchava's going to pick this one up. He's got Carson Woods, and that's broken up by Wartburg Knight. Brian Bassinger with the throw-in. As you see the student section there, Loras College students come out, and this one on top of the net. Have a saying around here, Duhawks supporting Duhawks, and they're doing just that tonight. Woody with another kick. Pretty much the same spot it's been at all night for him. Bottom of that R in Loras. Back of the head from Bassinger. And a nifty, swifty move. A throw in from Wartburg. We're going to stop at your play here. Looks like Coach Stevie McCarthy's having a word with a sub for Loras. Warming up earlier. And it looks like it's number 28. Excuse me. 21, Noah Reed, that's ready to come in for Loras. Reed, a sophomore from Griffith, Indiana. Osele tried to make it a stop, couldn't do so. So now the Knights got an opportunity and right into the hands of Benjamin Krogman. And he's waving his teammates to get up the field. Got a lot of momentum going on after that stop. Him and Woody have been busy all night on separate sides of the field. Bassinger gets up, connects with Kuchaba with a nice little kick there intended for Woods. But Beausoleil will get it, and this one off the head of Michael Brandt. Wartburg moving into Loras territory, something they've been doing all night, and it's another opportunity for them to score if they want to take the lead. Stopped by Cardenas and kicked out by Michael Kay. Connects with Solwell here is before this one rolls out, and it'll result in a Wartburg throw-in. Valenzuela there connects with a teammate, number 19, Yushan Gosin. Gosin from Lincoln, Nebraska. First time calling his name tonight. 22 and a half minutes remain in regulation. New rule the NCAA has implemented, no overtime in regular season games. We get a stoppage of the clock. So this game was to end now, it would end in a tie. And a yellow card for Solwell. Solwell, a freshman from Rockford, Illinois, and Noah Reed checks into the game for Loras.
Card number 14, Taylor Small.
Krogman hits, pats that one out. Off the head of Bassinger. And Krogman's got hops like Jordan. He gets up and grabs that one. Bassinger. When you need him most, he shows up. Krogman to Woods, Woods to Michael Kay, and Reed gets his first touch of the night. And another whistle in the Loras bench isn't happy about that one. Michael Kay. Coach McCarthy and that Loras bench was not happy with that call. Paul Devine. Off the head of Michael Brandt. Kuchaba gets in on it. Picked up by Woods, and another opportunity for Loras. And it'll get stopped by Woody. Bassinger with a header there. Carson Woods on a mad chase there. Woody's going to kick this one. An absolute laser to midfield. Brandt kicks it high up into the air, and this one hasn't touched the ground in a second, and it does there. And a stop by Noah Reed, the sophomore, making it happen early for his time on the field, but kicks this one right into the hands of Woody. Jumps up and grabs it. Beausoleil off the chest of his and then off the foot. And he'll stay with Loras here. Ryan Bassinger taking his time. Just under 20 minutes to play here in the second half. And Lucas Sampson will check in for Carson Woods. Sampson started the game, a senior from Wheaton, Illinois. Loras trying to make some last-minute substitutions. Bassinger. Comes into the screen, and this one still in play. Bassinger going to kick it. Kuchaba, and this one will be kicked out to Sampson. So still with Loras, but it'll be off the the leg of Jared Block. And the crowd giving it to Andrew Valenzuela. Trying to move up there, and they let him know he wasn't doing it right. Bassinger with the throw-in again. It's been in the same spot the past three throw-ins or so. A strong throw-in from Bassinger, and that's off the head of the senior here from Dubuque, Iowa, Jared Block. Kick from Woody, off the head of Kuchaba, off the shoulder of Block, and Ramirez will pick it up. He's got Noah Reed off to his right, and they'll connect. Noah Reed. Number 33 for Loras, Danny Galina Torres from Madrid, Spain, is in the game. If I'm not mistaken, he's checked in for Carson Woods, a much-needed break for Woods. He's came in beginning to the middle of the first half and has been in ever since. A lot of guys have been out there from the start. Kuchaba, Ramirez, Cardenas, Jared Block, Michael Brandt, Michael Kay. Bassinger gets tied up. It'll be a throw-in for Andrew. Directly off the head of Sampson, and this one is going to be a strong kick from Kuchaba. Just short of the 35, and Torres was gunning it down there. Jared Block gets that out of there as Ramirez stopped it from going to the Knights. And Torres, and ooh, a little bit of a shove, but I think he was maybe shoved or pushed first. Free kick from the Knights, and that one's off the head of Block. Torres trying to get in on the action. Number 15, Parker Shimmers. First time calling his name tonight. The senior from Minshaw, Wisconsin. And Krogman falls right on top of this one. Once again, waving his guys up. Just under 15 minutes to play here in the second half. And we're still tied 2-2. A lot can happen in 15. We'll see how this one ends up. Bassinger will kick this one out of bounds. And a throw in from number 4, Valenzuela. Cardenas playing some defense. Noah Reed playing some defense too. And Reed not happy with that call. Wartburg lining up in some type of line or stack positioning or formation. It'll be a free kick from number 10, Caleb Helleran. And a strong kick, and that one is off of Lucas Sampson. Pair of Duhawks check into the game. Matt Williams is one of them. Torres will check out. And it looks like Michael Kay will check out as well. Halloran with a corner. Reed and Sampson against the goalpost. Now Sampson evades that spot, and now it's Michael Brandt. Some Knights come crashing in, but that one's kicked way over the intended target. Bassinger with the throw-in. And Matt Williams, the senior, straight from here in Dubuque. Wartburg picks up right where they left off. Diego Rodriguez also checked into the game, number 20 for Loras. Krogman bobbles it, but ends up with it, and he falls right into that A. Gets right back up. Gets a pat on the back from Jared Block. And despite the two goals he's let up, he's had a phenomenal game tonight. All over the field, all over the goal. Just over the head of Bassinger. Noah Reed's going to kick that one. Try to connect with Matt Williams. And Williams will kick this one right to a Wartburg defender. That kick. Out of bounds. If we were playing football, that would have given Wartburg a 5-3 lead as a field goal, but instead, you got to get it in the goal, not through the uprights. Kuchaba. And Woody's running out, and he'll roll it to a teammate. Instead of taking his time trying to line it up and get his teammates down, he'll just roll it. Because we're 9.5 minutes left in regulation. Like I was saying before, unfortunately, there is no overtime, a new rule in the NCAA. No overtime in regular season games. So if this score stays the way it is, we'll end up with a tie. And I doubt neither team wants to end that way. Woods once again just throws it down. Off the head of Reed. Tried to get it off the head of Ramirez. Off the foot of Reed, and the Knights are going to pick it up. Another opportunity for them to score, and it's Cardenas with a stop there. We get a whistle, and it'll be Loras' ball. And some quick communication going on between a few Jayhawks, trying to work some things out. This is a huge opportunity for them to take the lead. Lots of time still left in the game. But you want to take advantage of the opportunities you get and of the chances you get, too. And this kick from Michael Brandt is going to go far. Tried to get it to Bassinger just over his head. It'll be picked up by Kuchaba. Now the Knights are going to kick this one past the 50 off the head of Jared Block. And now Sampson will pick it up. Sampson going to kick it to teammate. That's Diego Rodriguez. And he slips up. Diego still a little slow to get up here, and we're going to get a stoppage of the clock. Rodriguez limping a little bit. It appears to be okay as he walks this one off. 7:36 left in regulation, and Rodriguez amping up that crowd, trying to get him loud. It's all about Duhawks supporting Duhawks, and you see it right there. Kick from Brandt. We'll wait to see where it goes. A strong and high one. Off the head of a Wartburg Knight. Number 20. And Zuna Kimbo hands on his head. It'll stay with the Duhawks, and it looks like Kuchaba will get this free kick. Bassinger was ready for a throw-in, but it looks like it'll be a kick with the Duhawks. See on your screen some Duhawks warming up, getting ready to relieve perhaps some of those starters or whatnot. 7 minutes left to play. Kuchaba will take it. He'll fake that kick. And it's Wartburg's ball, so I'm not sure what they were planning there or what, but I doubt it worked out as they had planned. Because now it's Wartburg's ball, and it's another opportunity for them to take the lead. Sliding attempts from Kuchaba. This one's high up in the air as it falls down, and it's Diego Rodriguez trying to take it away and give it to his teammates. Off the foot of Sampson. Sampson's going to get it to Williams. And everyone's chanting, Matt. Sampson, and it's stopped. Number 15, Parker Shimmers. That could have been a game-saving save by Shimmers, the senior from Minshaw, Wisconsin. Could have had the play of his life right there. And that crowd getting into the game, you love to hear it. Ramirez and Kuchaba replaying what they just did, except on the other side of the field. And from the look on our screen, it looked like it was off of Wartburg, but the ref may have saw it differently. Matt Williams having a hard time trying to keep up with these Knights, but he's given his best effort, and that's all you can ask for. Noah Reed breaks it up momentarily, but it's picked up by Sam McDevitt. Connor Ulumba getting guarded heavily here. But the pressure backs off. Rodriguez gonna kick this one way down the field, and it'll go right to the foot of Brennan Woody, and Woody will boot this one in the opposite direction. Noah Reed tried to time that header, but he just miscalculated it, and now it's in favor of Wartburg here. Ramirez kicks this one high up in the air, and it falls just short of the 50, and now Wartburg has possession. Diego Rodriguez turning on the wheels as he tries to escape that. Ooh! The play keeps going, and Kuchaba gets it to Matt Williams, and I think that was perhaps a miscommunication between Williams and Kuchaba. And it looks like that injured Knight is back up on his feet, number 4. Andrew Valenzuela. Pair of Duhawks check into the game here. In for Diego.
In the game for Duhawks, number 22, Carson Woods.
Carson Woods checks in. For Loras, back into the game. Played a majority of that first half. Got a break early in the second, and now back in for the remaining 3 minutes, and looks like Taylor Solwell is down on the ground. Sampson Solwell appears to be okay, walking off under his own power, and looks like there was a yellow card given, and so the ref's going to document that real quick before we resume play. Coach Steve McCarthy signaling and calling over to Taylor Solwell to come over towards the bench. And a swifty move by Kuchaba. Turns around and fools the defender, and now he's stuck in the corner. And we'll get a whistle, and it'll be Wartburg's ball. Two and a half minutes left here to play. Either team's got to make a move and score a goal, otherwise we'll be ending in a tie. Kuchaba tries to break in there and break up that kick, but fails to do so. And now it's Solwell trying to make a move between the two defenders here, and this one will get to Andrew. Number 17, Evan Rizvik. This one off the head of Michael Brandt. And the ref signaling those two to get up. No Fowler called there, and Carson Woods trying to save it from going out of bounds. Instead, he'll kick it right to Woody at the five. Woody slips up on that kick, and that is going to be off of Samson's foot. Minute and a half here to play in regulation. And the energy is draining. Both players, both teams absolutely exhausted. And you can see it here in the final minutes of this game. Temperature's cold, been running around all night. 1 minute remains here in regulation. This one will roll out of bounds. It'll stay with Loras. Get another whistle here. And a last minute substitution. Matt Williams is going to check into the game. Looks like in for Solwell, and that clock is ticking as we approach 30 seconds. Loras has to score here if they want to take the lead and win this game. This one is going to be an overthrow from Bassinger. Oh, Woody better stop this. He does, and 20 seconds remain. Wartburg trying to move fast. 10 seconds left in regulation. If Wartburg can make a move, otherwise this one will end in a tie. Off the head of Ramirez. Off the head of Sampson. And so, Loras. Still wins. Excuse me. Claims the ARC with the best record as they advance to 10-5-1 overall. 6-1-1 in the conference. And Wartburg will move to, 8-1-8. And 3-0-5 in the conference. With a lot of rivalry in this matchup, a lot of sportsmanship as well. I know it was a big, tough, gritty, scrappy game between the two teams. But with a big rivalry comes with a big respect, too. So both teams played well. Both teams gave it their best effort. But in the end, the tie goes to the home team, Loras. Signing off here from the Rock Bowl. A 2-2 score will end the game and end the season for the Duhawks and the Knights. We'll see you next time they take the field. Have a great night.